This is Karnivool Sky Machine. I've done several Karnivool songs now. I'm just absolutely loving them. Really like their dynamic range and their creativity overall. You know, they're not trying to be anybody, it doesn't sound like. They're just doing their own thing. And you know, certainly, like I said earlier, like the way that they kind of ebb and flow through their songs, not just kind of staying in one feel the entire time or one theme the entire time, which I definitely appreciate a lot. Not sure which album this is off of, but this is from Density Records. So if you want to follow on YouTube, this is from the Density Records channel. Again, this is Karnivool Sky Machine. Here we go.
I keep staring at the sky.
Love that tom sound. I feel like his toms are tuned pretty high. It sounds like he's just doing the hi-hat with his foot. Really steady. Like eighth notes, maybe. A little bass coming in. Sounds like three different guitar tracks. There's one guitar way over here that you can just barely hear. Like the kick groove. Sounds like a halfway closed hi-hat. Yeah, those toms, man. Doom. I like this kind of dual guitar thing going on too. Too, like it's almost acoustic. Very clean tones. They just added a third one. Do they have three guitarists? Or is this all just layering? Is that a tambourine? What is that? It's not the hi-hat. Because earlier when he was doing this tom pattern, he was doing the hi-hat with his left foot. Is that acoustic? They do a lot of funky stuff with their guitar layer, no doubt. He's come back to this tom pattern three or four times now. Like pre-chorus kind of, and I still don't know if there's multiple vocalists or if this is all layering. Is that a piano too? You hear that, right? Over top. I feel like this is all still kind of just building towards something. I think I said pre-chorus like a minute ago. Just keeps going. Some very high bass notes. Are there two bass tracks? They're doing some weird stuff, like sonically in this song, as far as their mixing is concerned. Hopefully, somebody can show me the way because I'm not exactly sure what they're doing or how they're doing it. He's done this vocal tone a couple times in some other songs. Very intimate, like it's like he's almost kind of like doing it right in your ear. I like that. Yeah, it is acoustic. It sounds like it's two different acoustic guitars too. Or maybe just one acoustic and one very clean electric. Just hear just a tiny little bit of lead guitar coming in every now and then. It's weird, just very weird decisions. Something's coming in. Is that all bass? Sounds like it. It's the same tom pattern too. It's kind of hard because now the guitar and the vocals are kind of overshadowing it. Very identifiably acoustic now over here on the left. Still have a lead guitar on the right, doing some slow moving stuff. Overall, this whole feel is kind of chill because it's not using a whole lot of cymbal work. It's almost all toms. He's basically just only using cymbals at the end of the phrase. Now they're kind of spotlighting the guitar a little bit more. I mean, I guess it does make a little bit of sense why they're keeping it in the back until certain sections, because if it was like this the entire time, it'd be very hard to pick up what's actually going on. Solo. One quick comment before they maybe launch into a solo, unless this is it. Their drum grooves are very toolish, and I know that they get very tooled a lot, but like in the sense that they are hypnotic. You know, kind of doing the same thing over and over again, but it's cool enough and it's unique enough where you just kind of get lost in it. At least for me, I mean, that's something that I gravitate towards. And repetition is certainly part of hypnosis, you know, in any regard, whether it's, you know, through music or like some dude who's doing it on a show. Is that it? I don't want to look yet. That's got to be it. Sounds like a fade out. Yep. All right. That was Karnivool Sky Machine. Gotta be completely honest, not far up there in the Karnivool that I've heard so far. A little bit too much to that root groove over and over again, especially drum-wise. He just kept coming back to it over and over again, that kind of tom pattern. So there wasn't as much of the, you know, the drum work that I usually freak out about. I mean, it was a cool pattern, but it was constant almost the entire song. And I mean, I'm not saying that as a complaint, again, just an observation, because it does create that sort of hypnotic effect where you're, it's happening over and over again underneath everything so much that you just kind of lose track of it and lose track of yourself. At least I do, definitely. That's one of those things that I love about Tool and other bands that do that kind of thing. That's what I like about, you know, some electronic music is kind of getting that trance sort of thing. Again, a lot of unique guitar stuff. They must have at least two guitarists. They have to. Otherwise, they just do a ton of, layering and pedals or trigger stuff like on a stage when they're doing it live. There's no way that one dude can make all of those sounds. It's got to be at least two. And there were certain parts of this song where I felt like there were three different tracks, like all kind of going over on top of each other. A lot of bands do that. One of the biggest that I can think of off the top of my head is a lot of Red Hot Chili Peppers. especially when Frusciante was with them or is still with them. I don't even know anymore. He does a ton of layering in a great way. It's not I'm not saying this is a bad thing. I'm not trying to say like they're being lazy or they're cutting or taking shortcuts. It's just it's a choice, and they do it very well. Red Hot Chili Peppers does, and these guys do it very well in a different way. At least one or two instances where there were like three different tracks, two lead ones and an acoustic, or like three electrics, some that are on different, scales of cleanness, some with a little bit more, harsh edginess going on, a little bit more distortion. And then the lead track, which came in and out every now and then. That one section that I kind of pointed out was almost a solo, really wasn't. I started saying something about the drum track, I think. But yeah, just a lot of cool, interesting decisions with their guitar layering, which, hey, at the very least, is something to think about, something to try to figure out what's going on. I wouldn't say that I would pick out a ton of cool riffs from this song, which maybe says a lot about their other work, because their other work, I mean, certainly I feel like I would be able to pick out a few. This one, not as much. I feel like it was mostly the collection of everything that was going on at once. Bass work, I mean, I certainly mentioned it a couple of different times, and for these kind of bands, especially like on a YouTube recording, it's nice to just be able to hear something. And I'm sure if I could go back, I would be able to pick out more, but right now it's not really sticking with me. And then vocally, he definitely did a lot of the same stuff that he's done before. One part that I liked a lot that he brought out again was the kind of the soft, muted, not exactly muted, but just kind of intimate, not a whisper, but very, very, I don't know, man. I don't know the best. It's not laid back, just kind of quiet, quiet, soft singing, and it sounds like it's like right next to your ear. And I'm sure that that's the intended effect, is to have it be more personal and intimate and kind of enclosed within everything else that's going on. I think last time I heard a song like this from these guys, I used the word maybe claustrophobic, and I'm trying to say that in a good way, because it's certainly an effect that his vocals have, when they choose to strip everything away and it's just him and maybe a light drum track. I think at that point maybe he was doing some very, very, very subtle stuff on the hi-hat, just little tiny ticks, which is cool. I like that a lot. It just goes to show their dynamic range, which is something that I've pointed out about these guys over and over again. So I apologize if I'm repeating myself, but their dynamic range is just fantastic. Their ebbs and flows, and they're just the different variety of sounds they can do, and at different times and different structures, is awesome. I like this a lot. So again, that was Karnivool Sky Machine. There will be more from these guys coming. Thanks again for the suggestion.